Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fourth part of my Kitty Hawk 135th scale Pave Hawk build. Last time we glued the fuselage halves together, and now it's time to do a bit of cleanup on the seams. I'm using a water-based putty for this because I want to avoid sanding down the putty later. There is a lot of fine detail on the kit, and sanding down will damage this detail, something I want to avoid. What the water-based putty allows me to do is to take a Q-tip moistened with water and simply rub away the extra putty and smoothen the seam lines. The seam on the tail does not need any putty, but I will need to sand it down a little. Before I sand it down, I deepen the panel lines so that they are not lost during sanding. Right, these are the tail stabilizers, and I must say, these are rather delicate. Despite being as careful as I could be, I did manage to knock the parts off on more than one occasion. I now start masking the clear parts, and there are quite a few of them, starting with the main cockpit windscreen glass. The windows are fairly straight edged, so I used a thin masking tape to go around all the edges. If you have watched my previous videos, you will know that this is my preferred way to mask canopies, mostly on account of two reasons. Firstly, the edge on the tape is factory cut, so I get a very straight line, at least straighter than if I cut by hand. And secondly, the use of the hobby knife on the clear plastic is minimal, which reduces the chances of accidental scratches. The rounded edges were masked using Tamiya's bendable tape. Once the edges were done, the inside was covered with masking fluid. The doors were first painted black to match with the cockpit inside and then dry brushed with aluminium. I can now glue in the side windows and mask them with masking fluid. In hindsight, I should have used tape here. The fluid got wedged between the clear plastic window and the door, and it was a bother removing it. Finally, all the clear pieces can be glued in place. Please note, the pilots have now changed seats and the pilot's hand is no longer jutting out of the window. I had pointed out this problem in an earlier edition when I had the pilots in the wrong seats. Now to start putting together the engine and the sub-assemblies that go on top of the Hawk. Though I did not keep the engines open, I must say that they are beautifully detailed and with a little scratch building would look absolutely spectacular. The reason I had to close them was that I had already bought the crew and it would have looked odd to have the crew sitting inside the Hepta with the engine panels open. Time to glue the top on. I really like the detailing on the engines. The kit's fit is really nice, and once again the top settled in place with minimal push and pull. The engine covers did not fit snugly over the engines, leaving some really prominent gaps. These were later filled with putty and cleaned. I next completed the landing gear and glued it in place. The refueling probe was glued in place next. Now began the rather lengthy masking process. I could have stuffed the cabin with foam or sponge, but I was afraid I would knock off the seats. So I went with the more lengthy but safer tape option. I did, however, use sponge in the front windows. There are also a few photo etch parts and other tiny plastic parts that need to be glued in. This took surprisingly long, as it seemed that the list of tiny parts would never end. As I had mentioned before, some of the holes that I had drilled into the fuselage sides did not line up at all. These had to be filled back. Good thing I checked this before painting the kit. As I have said innumerable times during this build, please do not rely on the instructions. They are very poor and misleading. Check everything twice. Finally, I painted the kit with black. This will act as a primer as well as provide the base for some marbling. It took 4 coats of paint to cover this entire kit properly. Well then, fellow model makers, that's about all the time we have in this edition. Please do leave a like and a comment on the video. It really helps. Also, do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Next time we will paint the kit. Till then, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.